is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to you on a quick video. I wanted to let you guys know I got some new merchandise available, not just t-shirt anymore. I got different type of t-shirt, different type of shirts and logos that you can purchase on my spread shirt, and also hoodies now. We have expanded and added more to the channel and more merchandise for the brand. Thanks for supporting. It will be in the description and the links will be in the comment section below. Thanks for helping me and supporting the movement. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis. I'm going to check out the video. What is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to y'all with another quick video. We're going to talk about the San Antonio Spurs. Pick up some wing players that's needed. They re-signed Rudy Gay, who has been a solid contributor to their team, a guy that's been able to score on or off the ball, post up, knock down the mid-range. He always been a good commodity for them. They've been able to re-sign him the last couple years because they like what he brings to the table. And it's hard to find good wings that's for a good price in general. But you have to give them credit because they was able to even find Demarre Carroll. He obviously ain't the same player that he was when he got his first contract. They made him a priority by signing him right away as one of their first targets. He gave you 11 points, 39% from the field, 34 from three. He played 25 minutes a game at Brooklyn. Those numbers don't scream out loud that crazy, but Demarre Carroll never been really a shot creator. He never really been a guy that can get his own shot and carry an offense. He always been a player that, in the right situation with the right type of talent, he can be a great piece because he can switch and guard a lot of positions. He can knock down the three ball and he can get out in transition. He's just a teammate. He just do the things that you need for him to do when he's out there on the court. He's not going to try too much. He's not going to do too much. He's just going to stick to what the coach need him to do. I need you to stay in the corner. I need you to guard this guy. I need you to do this. And Demarre Carroll just goes out there and do it. They are paying him some double-digit salaries. But, like I said, it is hard to find good wings at that small forward position that can really do the things that these two dudes bring to the table. I like Rudy Gay a lot. I feel like he has been very good for the Spurs, especially coming off that Achilles injury. They took a gamble with him after he tore his Achilles, and he really showed that he still could be a quality wing. He played 69 games, gave you 50% from the field on 10 attempts, 40% from three on 2.7 attempts, gave you 80% from the free throw line, 7 rebounds, 2 assists, and 13 points. He only started 51 games after he played to 69, and those are quality minutes. Like, it's hard to find a guy that can do that for you. Only problem is he is on the older end of the deal. He's still a legitimate 6'8", 230. He's still a guy that can carry a bench if you need him to. He still can get his own shot very easy. Still explosive, a little bouncy, and he can give you some solid rebounding, like I said. So this is a quality player for a position you need. They need this position to be filled, and he does everything they need. And what he doesn't do, you can always use Demarre Carroll. Plus, you can use him at the same time. If DeMar DeRozan or somebody goes down, these guys can fill in that starting position for a short amount of time, for a couple minutes, and they can give you some great production for the price that you're getting them for. So I never been a huge Rudy Gay person, but then again, I never been a Rudy Gay hater. He's a solid, respectable guy, and people like playing with him. People like him, and I feel like at the end of the day, I don't see why the Spurs would not give him another contract, considering that this is a position of need. In my personal opinion, I like both of these pickups. And with Greg Popovich always finding ways to reinvent the offense and reinvent what they do defensively, he can do that with these two guys, as they are guys that can contribute. With this Spurs team, they still are far away from being a championship team, to be honest. But you still have Lonnie Walker coming back with another year of experience. You still got a development of Poeltl. You got Murray. You still got Derrick White. And you still got Bryn Forbes. So you got some quality players, some guards, some wings. You got DeMar DeRozan, who can play two and three. He is the best player on the roster, and you still got LaMarcus Aldridge for one more year. And even if he does decide to leave, you have the cap space that he will let go because he won't be on the roster no more. So they're going to be fun. They're going to be competitive, but they're going to need a lot more if they want to make it to the playoffs. DeJounte Murray, we really don't know what he's going to be, but if he can be what he was before or better, that would be a significant upgrade for them coming into the season. But at the same time, you can't be complacent because this year they barely made it to the playoffs. And next year is going to be even harder as a lot of teams are getting more talent and making more moves. And the free agency just is at its start. The Spurs are finding themselves in as a 9th or 10th best team in the West. But at the same time, it's about how you play, how you gel, and how you go out there and end and close, begin and close games. The Spurs are well coached. They are going to be prepared, and they're going to give you a run for your money for 48 minutes. The only problem is talent does matter in this league, and you only can go so far of what you have. And I think that they need to make some roster upgrades if they want to get back into that contention for the title. They're still good enough to be in the race and make it, but they're still far away from winning it all. And that's what I think they need to fill in this free agency, and that should be their biggest goal, even if they have to trade for that piece, which we don't know what the piece will be, but we do know they don't have it right now. So either somebody like DeMar DeRozan will have to have an exceptional season, one of his best season ever, which he is capable of, or this team can be a team that could potentially miss the playoffs. Let me know what you guys think. Is this team underrated, overrated? Do you think they do need to make some tweaks to this roster? Do you think they do need to try to go and get that other player, that other all-star? Or do you think they're fine? They got shooting. They got wings. They got guard play. They got some bigs that can do multiple things. And all it takes is them getting in the right position. And maybe that's true. But what's not true is that they're a title contender. They might still be able to make the playoffs. I'm not going to say that they're not. But it's going to be tough, and they're not going to be able to win the title. That's the thing, we're not used to the Spurs. You always think of the Spurs that hangs in there, they're always a threat, and they can always have a chance to make a big run and win it all. That's not the Spurs of the day, and that's the problem. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Check out my Facebook page, analysisplayground.com, link will be in the description, comment section below. Check out my website, analysisplayground.com, link will be in the description, comment section below. Thanks for everybody that likes on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes the videos. Thanks for everybody that comments. I like the activity that you guys have shown. I answer comments that make sense, if that makes sense. And also, at the end of the day, if you like this video, check out my older videos on my channel. I have many playlists. I break down rookies. I break down players. I break down summer league. I do cover the draft, and I got a mock draft up already. Not only that, I do podcasts, and I also talk about the game of basketball, whether it comes to summer league, free agency, trade deadline, buyouts, and also I cover top 10 discussions and stuff like that. So if you like this type of video, you like the NBA, check out my older videos and my playlists. I enjoy making these videos. You guys enjoy watching. I'm going.